With Denis Villeneuve's highly anticipated version of the classic sci-fi novel Dune by Frank Herbert headed to the big screen, we thought we would put a video together on everything you need to know about the movie. Whether you're completely new to the barren world of Arrakis or just in need of a refresher, we will take a look at the backstory, plot, world, and characters that make up Dune without giving away too much in terms of spoilers. Let's take a look. Now, it's difficult to summarize the intricacies of Dune in a 5-minute video, seeing as the history and lore span millennia, but we'll do our best here. Dune is part of a trilogy that includes Dune, Dune Messiah, and Children of Dune, and although this trilogy focuses on a more concentrated amount of time, there are many, many other works in the Dune franchise that venture through thousands of years of lore. The original Dune novel is told in 3 parts, although Villeneuve is seemingly breaking the book into 2, with Dune set to be a 2-parter. The story takes place in the distant future in a medieval-style intergalactic feudal society which consists of a series of noble families, such as rival houses Atreides, who are the primary characters of the story, and Harkonnen, and ruled by Padishah Emperor Shaddam IV. The feudal system is rife with political games, paranoia, and backstabbing as rival houses look to get a leg up on one another. Now, in the plot for the original Dune, the Atreides family, who inhabit the luscious and prosperous ocean planet of Caladan, are assigned by the Emperor the stewardship of Arrakis, a dangerous and barren sand world that is almost the complete opposite of Caladan, where water and resources are sparse. The planet is occupied by giant, monstrous sandworms who live underground and can consume people and vehicles with ease, as well as the native people, the Freemen, who live deep in the deserts and are known for their ferocious fighting abilities, ability to survive in adverse conditions, and their famous still suits that help to conserve the moisture from their bodies, as water is the most precious commodity on Arrakis. Now, while water might be scarce there, there is one substance that the planet has in abundance. Melange, colloquially known as spice, a drug that extends life and enhances mental abilities and is also necessary for space navigation, which requires a kind of multi-dimensional awareness and foresight that only the drug provides. But seeing as Arrakis is such a dangerous place, it's not an easy planet to rule, meaning the Atreides have their work cut out for them, especially with the secret schemes of Baron Harkonnen happening in the background. The Atreides know the challenge set out before them, but have no other choice but to accept. Also, without giving much away, Paul Atreides, son of the family's leader Duke Leto, is a vital character to the story's plot, with the character having prophetic dreams which often involve a mysterious woman he's never met. Now, these dreams lead to him being noticed by the Bene Gesserit, an exclusively female group that pursues mysterious political aims and wields seemingly superhuman physical and mental abilities. And they subject him to the Gom Jabbar test, a deadly test which causes blinding pain as part of an assessment of the subject's humanity, which can be seen in the trailer. But we're not giving any more away in terms of plot, because that would be spoilers! There are also a number of vehicles and equipment specific to the world of Dune, such as ornithopters, laser guns, Holtzman shields, and the aforementioned stillsuits. Moving on to the characters and casting now, you'll most likely know that the movie is insanely stacked with star-studded members in its ensemble cast. To start us off, House Atreides. Timothée Chalamet will be playing the main protagonist Paul Atreides, who, for lack of a better comparison, is a Luke Skywalker type with a big future on the planet of Arrakis. Oscar Isaac is playing his father and steward of Caladan, Duke Leto Atreides, who, again, for lack of a better comparison, is a Ned Stark type, ruling with both honor and dignity. Rebecca Ferguson's character is Paul's mother and Duke Leto's concubine, Lady Jessica, who is a member of the Bene Gesserit sisterhood. The weapons master of House Atreides, Gurney Halleck, is played by Thanos himself, Josh Brolin. Although in the book, Halleck is labeled as an extremely ugly man, and I don't really think that's entirely fair to Brolin. House Atreides' Master of Swords and the man who fights like a demon will be played by the one and only Jason Momoa. And now the other guys. Head of House Harkonnen, who I'm gonna sound like a broken record here, are for lack of a better comparison, the Lannisters to the Atreides Starks, is the sadistic Baron Vladimir Harkonnen, and is played by Stellan Skarsgård. While his henchman and nephew, Glossu the Beast Raban, is played by Dave Bautista. Moving on to Arrakis now, Freeman leader Stilgar is played by Javier Bardem, while Zendaya is playing the role of Paul's love interest, Chaney. Sharon Duncan Brewster is Liette Kynes, who's been gender-swapped from the book, the Arrakis-based planetologist and ecologist. Hot off his Suicide Squad success, David Dastmalchian is Piter DeVries, a Harkonnen Mentat, which is a profession that was developed to train people as a replacement to the computers and thinking machines which have previously been outlawed. While Charlotte Rampling is Reverend Mother Gaius Helen Mohiam, the person who conducts Paul's Gom-Jabbar test and is Lady Jessica's mentor. Now, in terms of behind the camera, as we mentioned, Arrival and Blade Runner 2049 director Denis Villeneuve is helming the movie, while Rogue One's cinematographer Greg Fraser will be DP on the project, as the brilliant Hans Zimmer provides the movie's score. Now, the movie's already screened at a number of international film festivals where it's picked up some rave reviews, but will officially hit theaters on October 22nd and will also be streaming on HBO Max, but don't get Villeneuve started on that one. The movie was supposed to be out already, but was of course delayed by the pandemic, as have most good things in life. Now, as we mentioned, a sequel is in the works, but given as this is Hollywood and other Dune adaptations, such as David Lynch's 1984 movie, haven't done so well, there is a chance it could fall through. But being optimistic, we could see a second half to the story in the next few years, probably closer to 2024 or 2025 than next year. Now, Villeneuve and Lynch's adaptations of the book may have hit the screen, but cult film director Alejandro Jodorowsky's adaptation was infamous for never getting off the ground. If you haven't seen it, I'd recommend checking out Jodorowsky's Dune to learn more about his ultimately doomed movie.